This module is all about how to create content that you can display on your site. But before we start doing that, we need to know what types of content there are. So let's review. By default, WordPress has two major content types, posts and pages. They look very similar, both in the back end and on your actual website. But what sets them apart? Well, it has to do with the role that the content you want to write will play on your site. There are a number of things that set pages and posts apart, which we'll discuss one by one in this video. Firstly, posts are content where the time of the publication is relevant. For pages, the publication date doesn't really matter. To really understand this, let's remember what WordPress started as, a blogging platform. On a blog, there is a clear distinction between these types of content. On one hand, you have blog posts, which you write and put up with a certain regularity. They need to be fresh and current, and to reflect what's happening in the world right now. This also means that as time passes, they may become less relevant or less accurate. Like if we're writing an article on how Google understands text, that might be completely different in 5 years. We'll have to edit that post or write a new one to show how it works then. So posts show what something is or was like at a point in time. On the other hand, your website also has a number of pages that are basically static and not subject to the passage of time. Like this arts and crafts page, where we put up some colouring pages and other creative stuff for children to enjoy. Nobody cares when this was published, and it won't be less useful 5 years from now. The same goes for our Yoast SEO plugin product page. It's simply not very relevant when a product was first launched for the visitors to that page. Of course, you still have to manage these pages, and you may want to make regular changes over time, but pages are just not as fleeting or as temporal as blog posts are. A second difference is the fact that for posts, it can matter who wrote the content. Visitors want to know who wrote a post. So when our founder, Yoast Tvalk, writes an article on technical SEO, for example, people know they can trust what he's saying. Moreover, posts are often written from a more personal perspective. For pages, the author is much less relevant. We don't display authors on our product pages or our About Us page, for example, because who wrote that page doesn't really matter to visitors. That's why WordPress displays authors on posts, but not on pages. Thirdly, posts are archived in WordPress, whereas pages aren't. You can show your recent blog posts, for example, in a widget. You also have pages that show archives of posts within certain blog categories or within certain tags. We'll come back to that in the next module, but your most recent posts show up at the top here as well. So again, there's the element of time and recency. Lastly, posts are meant to spark interaction. Your users can comment on posts, whereas they can't comment on pages. This makes a lot of sense when we look at the examples we discussed earlier. Comments make sense on informational blog posts or personal experiences, where you can have a discussion about something you think differently about. That doesn't really make sense on pages. So on pages, comments are disabled by default in WordPress. Well, there you have it. 4 important differences between posts and pages. The easiest way to remember it is probably that the content of posts can become outdated as the world, or your perspective on the world, can change. Whereas pages only need to be updated when you change something about how your website or your business works. So let's categorize some types of content. When should you use posts and when should you use pages? Well, just to give you an idea, these types of content are usually posts. Blog posts, obviously, news articles, announcements, think pieces, essays, tutorials, interviews, personal stories and case studies. And these types of content are usually pages. Product information, FAQs, terms of use, privacy pages, partner information, about us pages and contact pages. There are a lot more possibilities, but I'm sure you get the point. Now, on to the next video, in which we show you exactly how to write your posts and pages.